Hi there, Irene here. So on this video, we are going to be using a Dynamo script to create a randomized grid. So the idea behind this concept is that instead of you having to create each and every geometry and you having to make the, you know, conscious decision of like, how big do I want this to be? How small do I want it to be? How random do I want it to look? You can just use a Dynamo script to create that kind of geometry. And it's really cool because then if you don't like how it's looking, you can just use sliders to test out different shapes, different forms, different variations. So let's get started. Let's go into Revit and see how that gets done, shall we? Okay, small Irene on your bottom left corner, let's get to it. So I am on my Revit file, and just something to notice, I've switched my unit system to make sure that it's on meters. So I'm gonna go manage, and I'm gonna go Dynamo, and we're gonna start a new file. So I'm gonna go new, and here we are. So in previous videos, you can see the link above right now, you will see that we went over the process of creating a point and using numbers to give a positioning to that point. Now, if I want to create a grid, you might think that the easiest way to do that is just to create a bunch of points and then give a bunch of values to those points, like moving them. But that would make your script very messy very quickly. So instead, what we can do is we can use a sequence. So a sequence is going to be a series of points. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna type sequence, all right? And here we have. So my sequence is going to have a start point, it's going to have an amount of points, and it's going to have a distance between points. So what I'm gonna do here, these are all gonna be numerical values. So I'm just gonna go with the numbers. So number, there you go. And I'm gonna connect it to my start and control C, control V, control V. So I get three values, one for my start, one for my amount, and one for my number. And again, nothing is happening here because all my values are zero. So I'm gonna keep my start at zero. Let's say that my number is gonna be 5. And let's say that the steps between them are going to be 1. Okay, but we are still seeing nothing.
Confusion of the highest order.
And the reason for that is that although I have a sequence, I haven't really told Dynamo what do I want that sequence to be. See, I need to connect this sequence output with what is it that I'm going to be generating. So I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna say point. So I want the sequence to be a sequence of points. So now that I have my point, if I connect this sequence to X, now you can see I'm gonna go Control B to switch here on my preview. You can now see that my sequence is affecting Control B. It's creating basically a row of points that my row has 5 points and they are spread every 1 meter. Now, again, in previous videos, you saw how like if we connect the same output to 2 inputs, then you're basically going to get an angle, which is not really what we want here. Like you can see that, okay, I still have my sequence, but now it's going diagonal, which is not exactly what I want. I want a grid. I want the same value to repeat in X and I want it to repeat in Y, not to move along those. And the way that we're gonna fix that is by how my point interprets this input that is being given. So to do that, we're gonna click on our point node, right click on it, and here under the lacing option, we have basically, again, how that X and Y value is being interpreted. So by default, it's in auto, but what we're gonna do is we're going to select the option cross product. And that, voila, is gonna give us our grid. So again, I'm keeping this grid simple. If you would want your X and Y values to be different, then you would just take the sequence node with all of its input and kind of like copy paste that entire thing. But in this case, again, I just want to make my life a little bit easier, so I'm going to keep it as a square grid. I will make it a little bit bigger, so I'm going to leave it at 5 values, but let's say that they're going to be every 5. There you go. That's a bit more room to play with. Okay, so now we have our grid. What we're going to do next is we are going to generate the geometry that is going to be attached to that grid that we are generating. So in this case, to keep it simple, let's go with circles. So I'm going to go here on my library and I'm going to type circle and I'm going to click by center point radius. Click, and we are going to connect this guy to that guy, and voila, now we have a circle on each of my points. But as you can see, these circles are all uniform, which is not very random. So this is where the magic happens. What we need to do now is we want our radiuses to be random, randomly generated. So instead of me just creating a number node or a slider node and connecting that to my radius, I am going to create a randomizer script that will attach to my radius. So since we are going with randomizer, we are going to type here the word random.
Well, duh.
Pretty straightforward. And what we want here is a random list. So again, we're basically going to assign a set of values to like how we want things to be randomized. So here we have our random list. And what you can see here is that I need to feed it an amount of random numbers. So it's not just one value. We need a list of values that the randomizer list will pick up from. List, we need to create a list. So we're gonna go here and search for list. And here is my list create. We're gonna create our list. And we are going to connect this list to this amount, but we're missing information. So we're missing a bunch of things here, don't worry. So what we're gonna do here, we need one more thing, and that is going to be another numerical value for our list. So let me move these guys here to make it a little bit easier. And what I'm gonna do is, instead of just using the number, I'm gonna use the slider, because again, the benefit of the slider is that it's going to allow you to play with values a little bit more easily. So I'm gonna go slider, number slider, and here we go. We're gonna connect it to my item. Ah, okay, that's a little bit better. I'm gonna expand here for my values. Let's say that my minimum is gonna be 1, my maximum is gonna be 5, let's do 10. So remember, this is for the list, so this is their randomizing, and let's say 0.5 for the step. And if I connect this to radius, nothing is happening except that all of my circles have disappeared. This is not what we want. Now, here's the thing. Your randomizer list has to work with the number of circles that you have on your screen. And the way that it's going to pick up that is going to be by the numbers on your sequence. So basically, how much by how much is your grid, your X and Y or X, Y, Z. So what you want to do here is that you need to have the same number of items here as the highest value on your grid. So right now my grid is 5 by 5, so the number of items on my list should be 5. But for example, if I have grid that is 4 by 6, you would have to go with 6. So I'm gonna come here and I'm gonna click on this plus to get 5 items. So item 0 is the first one, so I need 4 more. 2, 3, 4, 5, there you go. And I need to connect this same slider to all of those additional items. Because again, remember, just because they're here, they're not doing anything. I need to connect them to an input. So connect, 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 and bam. So now you can start seeing the little circles appear. And what I can do now is I can play, see, there you go, they start appearing. So see, this is the fun of scripting with Dynamo. Instead of you manually having to decide the radius of each of these circles, now you can play with this slider to see all the different variants. And you can also play with these values to see what other results you can get. So let's say I'm gonna say that my minimum is 0, my maximum is 100, and my step is every 0.1, I don't know. And if I come here and I start sliding, I'm gonna get different results. So what I can do is I can play with the slider until I see something that I like. Ooh, I'm liking that one. Yeah. So let's say I'm gonna keep this guy. So there you go, Control B, so we can check. See, that is my randomized grid of circles. So this one is really cool. Again, think about any kind of design where you have a same repeating shape, but with different values. I keep on thinking about these like minimalist displays where you have just like a bunch of platforms and they're all kind of like different heights or whatnot. But here we're playing with different radiuses. So let's finish this guy up, because remember, right now we just have circles, lines. We don't actually have geometry. So what I'm gonna do is I am going to make these circles into a solid geometry. And the way that we're gonna do that is, first of all, I need to create a surface. So basically a skin that will follow the outline of my circle. So I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna go surface. And you're gonna get a bunch of different options as always, but we're gonna go with patch, which basically works the same way that floors, ceilings, roofs work in Revit, which is that you have a boundary and then the geometry will fill that boundary. So that would be by patch. So I'm gonna select, connect. Oops, I think I moved my slider by accident. See, I have too much fun with this. Sure, so let's say we're gonna go with that. And now, so now I have my surface, this is just flat. Usually you're going to want things to have at least some thickness. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the extrude node. So again, you have a couple of options. Here what I'm gonna do is I'm going to extrude in a direction. So basically it's just gonna follow, or you know what, let's do extrude as solid. Yes, because if I just use these top here, it's going to extrude it as a skin, so it's gonna be more kind of like a ring. So if you would want just like a hollow ring, you can use just the extrude, but I want it to be solid, so it has kind of like a bottom and a top. So I'm going to extrude as solid with distance. And again, what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna connect my surface as my curve. Oops, no. Instead of that, I am going to delete this guy and connect it there. There you go. So now all of my cylinders are the same height. Because again, I don't have any input for the distance. So I could make it so they all have the same height, but if I already have my randomizer, what I can do is I can also randomize the heights. So all I have to do is take this value here and connect it to my distance. And see, now both my diameter and my height of my circles is randomized. The other thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna reduce the distance between them a little bit. Let's make it maybe like 3, 2. I want them a little bit closer. There you go, see? Now you can appreciate them a little bit more, a little bit better. Gorgeous. All right, and as before, if I want this to actually show in my Revit file, remember if I minimize here, this one here. If I minimize here, remember, you're just gonna have a preview. which is not really what we want right now. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm going to make sure that I import this geometry into Revit. So I'm gonna go import, and we're gonna go with import geometries. So it brings everything in. Where's my import? Hello? Oops, import. What's going on? Import. There you go. Geometries, there she is. And we're gonna connect it. Boop, and now they are in my model. So now that we have a little bit of a bigger script, I want to show that you can use groupings to make it a little bit easier to figure out what the hell is going on. So for example, let's say that, okay, I've created my script, but I wanna make it in such a way that it's gonna be relatively easy for me to come later on and modify things. But I wanna make it easier for me to know what things I need to modify. So what I can do is I can create groupings to kind of like direct my view. So let's say that these, all of the things that I have here is what allows me to create my grid. So I can select all of these nodes, right click, and I can create a group. And what I like the most is that it gives you this kind of like color cue, but then you can also double click here and say, well, this is the grid part. If you want to change the color, you can right click and give it whatever other color you want. You can also remove from groups. So for example, if you added something by accident, you can select that node and remove it from the group. Let's say that I'm going to come here and select this part here, and I'm going to group that, and I'm going to call it randomizer. See, so it's just little visual things that make it a little bit easier to work with Dynamo. And that's going to be it for this video. Hope you liked it, hope you find it useful, and I will see you next time. Bye.